Good morning, students. In the yesterday's class, so we have defined the capacitor. So what is the principle of a capacitor that we have seen? The principle of the capacitor, as you have seen, it is we want to store more and more number of charges on a conductor. Because of that, some arrangement we have done there. What is that arrangement? If this is our conductor on which we want to store the charge, so 1 8, and the outer end of it we have so that if positive charges are stored here, so negative charges are stored in this. So this is an arrangement. We say it as the capacitor. It consists of two conductors. We want to charge one of the conductor. So because of that, we ground the other conductor. So this arrangement we say it as a capacitor. This whole arrangement we say it as a capacitor, where we want to store more and more charges. Okay. So now, how we define the capacitance of a capacitor? If it is on this, if plus Q charges are storing on this minus Q charges are storing on this. If plus V is the V plus is the potential on this, V minus is the potential on this. How we define the capacitance of capacitor? So what is the charge on the capacitor? So don't take it as plus Q, minus Q, the net charge is zero. So we have charged by plus Q. So these are induced charges. So we have charged only by plus Q, whereas these are induced charges. We cannot take it as the net charge of this capacitor as plus Q and minus Q. Okay. So what is the charge on the capacitor? Charge on the either magnitude of either of the charge on these. So we can say it as Q. And what is the potential difference between these two plates? Potential difference between these two plates is V plus minus V minus. So what charge we have given to this, and because of that charge, what potential difference is developed between these two? What potential difference is developed here. So this ratio we say it as the capacitance of the capacitor. The ratio of what charge we have given and what potential difference is developed there. Okay. In other way, the best way of charging a capacitor, how it is? If these are the two conductors, so what the best way we do? We connect a battery to this, a cell we connect to this conductors, to this metal plates. So what happens? The negative charges from this plate, they are attracted by this positive terminal of the cell, so that positive charges will induce on it. Positive charge, because electrons have left this, electrons have left this conductor. So because of that, the positive charges will be there. So as the positive charges are there, there will be negative charges will induce. Negative charges induce there. So what charge the battery has, what charge the battery, this cell has given to it, the cell has given a charge of Q. To what extent it will give the charge to it? Till the potential. What is the potential difference here? We say it as EMF. Those things we will see later. So what is the potential difference here? That potential difference has to develop between these two conductors. So till there, it goes on giving the charge to this. In the sense, it goes on removing the negative charges from this plate. Till, to what extent? Till the potential of this becomes, potential difference between these two plates becomes equal to the EMF of this. To that extent, it goes on removing the negative charges. In the sense, to that extent, it goes on giving the positive charges to this plate. How much positive plate it has given? Q positive charges it has given. What is the potential difference it has developed between these two plates? So what is here? So that's what I am writing here. It is Q divided by the potential of positive plate minus potential of negative plate. So that this is the potential difference between these two conductors. So this ratio we say it as capacitance of a capacitor. So how we are defining it? So this potential difference, what we have? So this potential difference, I want to make one quote. Potential difference between these two, I want to make unit. Unit potential difference, I want to maintain between these two plates. What charge I must give here? To this, what charge we have to give here? So that charge is said as capacitance of this capacitor. Capacitance of this capacitor. What it is? To develop a potential difference of 1 volt. What charge we have to give to this capacitor? 1 volt in the sense, the unit, potential difference I want to maintain between the two conductors. What charge I must give here to this? So that charge we say it as the capacitance of this capacitor. So previously in the yesterday's class we have defined the capacitance of a conductor, so which is a little different from the capacitance of a capacitor. For this arrangement we are defining the capacitance of the capacitor. So in the previous class, I was explaining the capacitance. It depends on the size and shape. It depends on the size and shape of the two conductors what we have used. So it depends on. So what is the nature of the medium between the two conductors? What is the nature of the medium between these two conductors? Okay, so it depends on nature as well as the size and the shape of these conductors. So based on this size and shape of the conductors, we have different types of capacitors. So those are the different types of capacitors are parallel plate capacitor. Spherical capacitor, cylindrical capacitor, so these are the different types of capacitors that we have, but main principle is the same. So we have such two conductors. One of the conductor is earth. The main principle is same, but the shape and size of these capacitors are different. Because of that, we have these three types of capacitors. But for our syllabus, we will derive the expression for the capacitance of parallel plate capacitors, and I'll give you the direct expressions of the capacitance of parallel plate capacitors of these two capacitors. So for our syllabus we have this parallel plate capacitor. We have to find the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. capacitance of parallel plate capacitor. We'll find the expression for this. So this capacitor So this capacitor, it consists of two parallel plane conductors. The area of each of these conductors is A. A is the area. Area of the conductors. So what is the separation here? The separation between these two plates is D. D is the separation between the two plates is D. Okay. So sigma is the magnitude of the charge density on each of these. Sigma is surface charge density. Okay, so what it is? We have two parallel plane conductors. Each of area A separated by a distance D. Let sigma be the magnitude of the surface charge density on each of these conductors. Okay. So that what is the charge on the conductor? Magnitude of charge on this conductor. So we know sigma is equal to Q by A. Q is equal to sigma into A. Q is equal to sigma into A. What is that? Magnitude of the charge on this is Q is equal to sigma into A. Call this as 1. So what I want to find out? Capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So what is my formula? C is equal to Q by P. Potential difference. C is equal to charge on it and the potential difference between the two plates. So now what I have to find out? Charge is Q is equal to sigma A. I have to find out the potential difference between the two plates. So for that, what I do? What is the electric field between these two plates? So by using the electric field relationship between the electric field and the potential difference, we'll find out expression for the potential difference there. So before, what is the electric field between these two capacitors. What is the direction of the electric field? So because of this positive charges, the direction of the electric field is in this way. Electric field is in this way. Okay. Because of positive charges, because electric lines of forces will start here and it will start at the positive charge. Okay. So electric field will be in this direction. How about negative charges? Because of this plate, what is the electric field between these two? How it is? So because of this also, see, you can see electric lines of forces will terminate at negative charge. So because of this, if I say this plate B, this is A and this is B, because of the charges on the plate B, so what we have? Electric lines of forces will be in this way. So this is electric field, electric lines of forces, because of what I marked red, those are electric lines of forces because of the positive charges. What I marked in blue color, those are electric lines of forces because of these negative charges. Okay, in the sense, the electric field due to the positive charge and electric field due to the negative charge, both are in the same direction. Both are in the same direction. Okay, so and what we have found using Gauss law, electric field due to a plane sheet, in the previous chapter, electric field due to a plane charged sheet. So what it is? It is because of one, electric field is equal to, because of positive charge, it is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. Sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So exactly in the same direction we have because of this plate also. So because of negative plate, also it is sigma by 2 epsilon naught. So that the net electric field between the two capacitors, the net electric field between the conductors, electric field between conductors is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon naught. This is because of positive plate. Sigma by 2 epsilon naught, it is because of so net electric field is equal to sigma by 2 epsilon plus sigma by 2 epsilon naught is equal to, it is sigma by epsilon naught. This is the electric field between the two charged conductors. It is E is equal to sigma by epsilon naught. We have added these two because the direction of the electric field, because of the positive charge and because of the negative charge, both are in the same direction. Because of that, the two fields we have added, and the net electric field we got it as sigma by epsilon naught. Okay, but our aim is to find out the potential. So we have E is equal to dV by dr. E is equal to dV by dr. Or dV is equal to E into dr. dV is equal to E into dr. So what is here? The potential difference between the two conductors. Potential difference between two conductors. So what it is? If I say this as V, E is equal to E into V is equal to E into dV, E is equal to E into dr. So what is the separation between these two? Separation between these two is dV. I can write it as potential difference is equal to this V is equal to E into dV. Okay. So what is E here? E is, just now we have found, it is sigma by epsilon naught. Okay. Call this as equation 3. Of capacitance of capacitor is equal to C is equal to Q by V. What charge you have stored on it? So from equation 1 it is sigma into A. From equation 1 it is sigma into A. From equation 3 V is sigma into d by epsilon naught. So this is sigma and this is sigma get cancels. So capacitance is equal to epsilon naught will go up epsilon naught a by. So this is the expression for the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitors, epsilon naught A by d. So on what factors it depends? It depends on area of the conductors. More the area, more will be the capacitance. It depends on the nature of the medium, epsilon naught, permittivity. It depends on nature of the medium, and also it depends on the separation between the two conductors. Less the separation, more will be the capacitance. Capacitance and separation, they are inversely proportional to one another. So So less the separation, more will be the capacitance. So in this way, so this is our expression for the capacitance of a parallel plate capacitor. For other two types of capacitors, spherical as well as cylindrical, so the derivation of the capacitance of that capacitor is not for our syllabus. So just I am giving you what is the expression for capacitance of the capacitance of spherical capacitor. So exactly in the same way, there should be two conductors. So here also, for these capacitors, what we have, if it is spherical, this is one sphere. There is a other sphere outside this. There is other sphere outside this. Okay, if it is charged inside, if it is charged positively, so like this, the negative charges will induce on the closer side of or inner side of the spherical conductor. Negative charges will induce on the inner side, so that the farther side we can ground it. We can ground the farther side. Okay. So if A is the radius of the, if A is the radius of the inner sphere, this B is the radius of the outer sphere. So it will be exactly like a sphere, two spheres, one inside the other. The inner sphere is charged positively, the outer sphere is charged negative. It has, it induces a charge of a negative charge. The other end of it is grounded. So that the capacitance of this will be C is equal to, it is 4 pi epsilon naught. A into B divided by, it is B minus A. You can write it like this. Where A is radius of the inner sphere. A is radius of inner sphere. B is radius of outer sphere. So this is our expression for the capacitance of a spherical capacitor. For a cylindrical capacitor, so we have one cylinder like this. This is the inner cylinder, and there is outer cylinder. So this outer cylinder is grounded. Okay. If positive charges are induced in the inner one, negative charges are induced on the outer, it will be negative charges. So if A is the radius of it, if a is the radius of the, if this is a, this outer radius of the outer sphere this is b, and l is the length of the cylinder is l. L is length of the cylinder. A is the radius of, if you take this as the axis of the cylinder, okay, A is the inner radius, radius of the inner cylinder, whereas B is the radius of the outer cylinder. L is the length of the cylinder. So what is the expression here? So here C is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught. It is C is equal to 2 pi epsilon naught L by log to the base C, log to the base C B by 2 pi epsilon naught L log to the base C, which I can write it as ln, ln B by A, where L is the length of the cylinder, A is the radius of the inner cylinder, outer cylinder, L is the length of the cylinder. So this is our expression for the capacitance of a cylindrical capacitor. So next is a very important concept, combination of capacitors. So if such capacitors, more than two capacitors, if they combine, if we arrange them in a different way, what is the effective capacitance of those capacitors if we are combining them in a different way? So that we say as a combination of, it is combination of capacitors. So there are two types of combination here. The first one is series combination सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कैपेसिटर्स एंड सेकेंड टाइप ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशन इज पैरेलल कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ कैपेसिटर्स. वी आर फाइंडिंग द इफेक्टिव कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ दीज कैपेसिटर्स व्हेन दे आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज एंड व्हेन दे आर कनेक्टेड इन पैरेलल. ए वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एक्सप्रेशन हियर. So series and parallel combination of capacitors, effective capacitance we are finding. So what it is, one by one we will see. First it is a series combination of capacitors. So what is here? We have a capacitor the capacitance of this capacitor is C1 the capacitance of this capacitor is C1 There is a other capacitor, second capacitor. The capacitance of this capacitance is C2. Third capacitor. The capacitance of this capacitor is C3. We have connected them. How it is? If it is a first plate of, if this is a first plate of the C1, this is a second plate of the C2. First plate of the C2, second plate of C2. First plate of C3, second plate of it is. Second plate of C3. So how we are combining these capacitors? We are combining in this way. How? The second plate of C1 is connected to first plate of C2. Second plate of C2 is connected to first plate of C1. End to end. The last two plates, which are at the extreme end, that is first plate of C1 and second plate of C3. So they are connected to the cell. They are connected to the cell. If the arrangement is so, only the extreme plates of the capacitors, only they are in contact with the cell, whereas other plates in between, these plates are not directly in contact with the cell. So end to end, there is a connection here. Such an arrangement we say it as series combination of capacitors. So the capacitance of this is C1, C2, C3. All the capacitance, they are same. Sorry, they are different. In a sense, maybe their area of the plates what we have taken, or it may be the separation between the capacitors we have changed. Somehow they have got the different capacitance. The first one has capacitance of C1, second one has C2, and the third one has C3. Okay. What happens here? So this cell has an EMF of V. It has a potential difference of V. Okay. So as I mentioned earlier, till the system potential difference becomes V, till there it goes on supplying the charge. Goes on supplying the charge in the sense, in other way, it goes on pulling the negative charges from it, from these plates. Okay. So first, the positive terminal of the cell is connected to the first plate of C1. First plate of C1. What happens here? It starts to pull out the electrons so that positive charges will left out in this plate. Say, for example, I have taken some 5 electrons, are it has removed some 5 electrons, 5 electrons, so that on the metal plate there are 5 positive charges. So which will induce 5 negative charges at the closer side of second plate of C1, at the closer side of second plate of C1. Whereas the 5 negative charges have come close to this, means there will be 5 positive charges on the farther side of it. 5 positive charges are induced on the farther side of this second plate. So this is a conductor. What I have marked here is a conductor. It is an electrical conductor. Ideally, it is a best conductor. Ideally, let us take. If this is the conductor, what these positive charges does? So these positive charges start to attract the electrons, negative charges, which are present in this first plate. In this first plate, the negative charges what we have, it starts to attract. So those electrons through these conductors, it will come here. They will nullify. If one electron from this plate comes out, generating a positive charge here, that one electron, what it does, it will nullify the positive charge here. Second electron comes out, generating a positive charge here. Second electron will nullify this second positive charge. Next, third electron comes out, generating a third positive charge. So that electron, that third electron will nullify this. Next, fourth electron will comes out, generating a positive charge here. So that electron will nullify it. Fifth electron comes out, generating a positive charge here. It will nullify this positive charge. So whatever positive charges are there on the farther side of second plate of C1, second plate of C1. Okay, so those charges will accumulate here because it has pulled the electrons from it. Electrons from this plate, and these positive charges have nullified. So electrons will induce on the closer side of this plate 2 of C2, and positive charges will induce on the, once again the electrons from this plate, it starts to remove the electrons from this plate. So those electrons, they will nullify these positive charges. Okay, so once again the five negative charges will induce on the closer side. Five positive charges will induce, so that will be nullified by this negative charge. So what we have observed, for one example I have taken, if five positive charges here, exactly five positive charges are here, and exactly same five positive charges here. So what happens in the series combination? The charges on each of the capacitors remain same. This is very important. The charges on each of the capacitor remain same, whatever may be their capacitance. One may be large, one may be small. Their capacitance of capacitor may high or may low. But when they are connected in series, when these capacitors are connected in series, the charge on each of them remains same. The charge on each of them remains same. So the charge on this is Q. 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 So charge on each of the capacitor, though their capacitance is different, charge on each capacitor is same. So we have our expression, C is equal to Q by V. C is equal to Q by V. So charge on each of them is same. Charge is constant. So if their capacitance is different, the potential drop across each of them should be different, because C is equal to Q by V, charge is same. The potential drop across each of them should be different. How it is? capacitance is inversely proportional to, capacitance is inversely proportional to potential difference. Where capacitance is more, potential difference across that capacitor will be less. Where capacitance is less, potential difference across that capacitor is more. So that the potential drop across this, if V1 is the potential difference here, V1 is the potential difference, potential drop across this, V2 is the potential drop across this, V3 is the potential drop across this capacitor. So, which has got more capacitance will have less potential difference, or potential drop is less across there. So that the charge in each of them, when they are connected in series, the charge on each of them remains same. Okay. In such a way that, so this V should be equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. So what is this, sir? V1. So V1 is equal to, we have our expression as C is equal to Q by V. V is equal to Q by C. So V1 is equal to, Q by C1. V2 is equal to potential drop across the second capacitor. So what it is? It is Q by C2. It is Q by what is the potential drop across the third capacitor? It is Q by C. V1 is equal to Q by C1. V2 is equal to Q by C2. V3 is equal to Q by C3. Such that V is equal to, it is V1 plus V2 plus V3. Substituting these values in it, what it is? V1 is equal to, it is Q by, V2 is equal to Q by C2. It is Q by C3. So V is equal to Q by C1 plus Q by C2 plus Q by C3. So that V is equal to, if you take Q common from this, it is 1 by C1 plus 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. So this is V by Q is equal to, what is left out? 1 by C1, 1 by C2 plus 1 by C3. Okay. So we have, what it is? When a potential of V is applied to this arrangement, when a potential difference of V is applied to this arrangement. So what it is? It is storing a charge of. It is storing a charge of Q. Instead of using all the three, if we have only one capacitor, instead of having these three capacitor, if we have only one capacitor, so what it is? Its capacitance, I take it as C. What charge it can store, same charge it will store. A single capacitor will store. Q is the amount of charge it has to store. Exactly Q amount of charge it is storing. When a potential difference of, when a potential difference of V is applied to it. When a potential difference of V is applied to it, same thing we have done. When a potential difference of V is applied, then on all these Q amount of charge is stored. We have one single capacitor whose capacitance is C. On it Q is the amount of charge stored when a potential difference of V is applied. Then this capacitor is said to be equivalent capacitor of these. What these three can do work, same work is done by just one. Same work is done by just one capacitor. We say it as equivalent capacitance of this. Okay. So, what is the equivalent capacitance? Just since it is in series, we will write it as a Cs. We write it as a Cs. So this is Cs is equal to, it is Q by V. Or this is Q by V, but I want, what is the value of V by Q? This implies V by Q is equal to 1 by Cs. V by Q is equal to 1 by Cs. So this is our equivalent. When Cs is equal to, if the capacitance of this capacitor is Cs, it is storing Q amount charge for a potential difference of V. So V by Q is equal to 1 by Cs. So if I say this as expression 1, this as expression 2, this as expression 3. So we have in the left hand side here v by q. Here also we have left hand side here v by q. So what I can write is 1 by cs. Instead of this v by q, what I am writing is 1 by cs is equal to. So it is 1 by c1 plus 1 by c2 plus 1 by c. So reciprocal of the equivalent capacitance. Reciprocal of the equivalent capacitance is equal to reciprocal of the equivalent capacitance when they are connected in series is equal to sum of the reciprocal capacitance of each capacitor. So this is our expression for the equivalent capacitance of the capacitor when they are connected in series. Reciprocal of the equivalent capacitance is equal to sum of the reciprocal capacitance of each capacitor. And other things, what you have to remember here, the charge on each of the capacitor is the same when the capacitors are connected in series. The potential difference across, the potential drop across these capacitors is inverse to their capacitance of their capacitor, inversely proportional to capacitance of their capacitor. And sum of the potential drop across these is equal to, so what the EMF of the cell you have chosen or what potential difference you have maintained between these two. Okay, so these things you should remember here. So in the tomorrow's class we'll derive the expression for parallel combination of the capacitor and also some tricks how to calibrate this CS, all those things we will get. Okay, thank you.